This is us about to release two baby sharks into the wild that we have literally raised from the dead.
And then it was kind of like, well, this is a little bit crazy.
The story that led us here is absolutely unbelievable.
Nobody else in the world had actually done this.
And it might hold the key to protecting endangered sharks all over the world. We are Planet Wild. Welcome to Mission 17. This is a story of an ordinary man whose discovery has given life to hundreds of sharks and may save thousands more in the future. To meet this man, we sent Phil to a very special island. Can you guess which one?
It's home to over 200 species of fish, flourishing underwater ecosystems, and 36 different species of sharks, making this one of the most biodiverse areas in Europe. Welcome to Malta. We are here to save baby sharks that used to get killed by the hundreds each year. And I know what you're thinking. If you're afraid of sharks, trust me, so was I. That is, until I learned a bit more about them.
We all know great whites and tiger sharks who make for scary villains in countless Hollywood movies. Besides the fact that even those rarely attack humans unprovoked, there are actually over 500 more shark species in all shapes and sizes that have the most interesting and unique features, but very little to be afraid of. And that is certainly true for the shark at the center of this mission, as you can probably guess by its name. Let me introduce you to the catshark. Well, it doesn't look quite like this, but still pretty cute, I think. It gets its name because of its cat-like eyes, spotted skin, and sleek cat-like movements. And just like cats, it likes to take a nice long nap in the sand after a successful hunt. As predators at the lower end of the food chain, catsharks play a vital role in the marine ecosystem by regulating the population of their prey.
We need sharks to have healthy oceans, and Malta specifically needs a strong catshark population for its beautiful, thriving marine ecosystem. An ecosystem that a British diver fell in love with 11 years ago.
I always had an interest for sharks, except when I started looking around, nobody was doing anything about sharks. Nobody was researching them, nobody was educating people about them. So I started to read books, I started to speak to people.
What Greg discovered was shocking.
More than half of all shark species in Malta are threatened with extinction. And this is a global trend, as shark populations worldwide have crashed by more than 70% in just 50 years. The main reason is overfishing. Even though sharks often aren't even targeted, they end up getting caught as bycatch. A fact about sharks that you might not know is that 40% of them are oviparous. They lay eggs. In fact, some of the most oddly shaped eggs that you will ever see. Greg noticed that some of the dead catsharks on the market were carrying eggs. And that's a huge problem, because these animals need several years to reach sexual maturity. And they only carry 2 eggs per term. That means they can't reproduce quickly. The bycatch of these unborn babies is a double tragedy, as they don't hold any value for the fishermen. Their death is a pure accident.
We basically found a small spotted catshark egg protruding from a female shark. We picked it up, we had a look at it, and we thought, wow, what do we do next?
Greg's curiosity was awakened. He put the egg in an aquarium and added an air filter and air stone just to see what would happen.
And to our amazement, it started to develop. And then it was kind of like, well, this is a little bit crazy. Is it really possible that we could take an egg from a dead shark and allow it to develop and put it back in the sea?
It would take 2 years of trial and error to actually get there.
Nobody else had done this in the world, so this was a real steep learning curve, lots of trial and error. Is the aquarium suitable? Can we get enough eggs? Is this a process that we can continue?
But Greg was determined to find a way, and he ended up pioneering a new method of shark conservation in Malta that could be applied by conservationists worldwide.
The crazy thing, Greg did all of that by himself at first, literally from his garage.
Over time, his work gained recognition. He wrote a paper on his method, built a team, and founded Shark Lab. Today, they're collaborating with the National Aquarium of Malta and have already saved over 300 cat sharks.
And this is how it works.
We're getting up at 4 a.m. Greg and his team visit the market every other day. It took a while to gain the trust of the local fishermen.
Today, the team is well respected down here, and it's really a collaboration. Many fishermen have come to visit Greg's shark releases as they are interested in a healthy ecosystem as well. Greg found a female shark that most likely has eggs inside.
So, we're moving into a back room of the market to examine it.
Yep. So how do we know if he's carrying eggs?
Okay. So if you just gently feel along this edge here, you start to feel something quite...
Oh, yeah.
And the same on the other side. So if you're putting the knife, obviously it's not very beautiful to look at. But this is giving us the chance to save a shark.
Everything the shark embryo needs to grow and evolve in the next month is inside the egg case. And inside Greg's garage, which brings us to step two, incubating the eggs.
So in hopefully 2 or 3 weeks' time, we'll start to see a very tiny embryo develop. And then soon, hopefully, we'll have a small baby shark moving around the top.
What seems so easy in hindsight took a lot of failed attempts to figure out.
The biggest problems that we found is that we were collecting eggs and at a certain point they stopped developing. And what we actually discovered is that if we have the aquarium set below 22 degrees, it appears to be safe for the development. The mortality dropped significantly. So that was a real game-changing move.
With that figured out, it's time for step three. Once the embryos are getting ready to hatch, the team brings them to Malta's National Aquarium, where they will grow up over the coming 12 months.
All the small catsharks that you see here have actually started to evolve in Greg's garage.
Once they are old enough, our baby sharks are ready to be released into freedom. A big day and our long-awaited final step.
In this box that I'm holding right now, there are two catsharks, about a year old and ready to be released. It will be theirs and mine first proper dive in the open ocean. I can sense some excitement and some nervousness here, and I'm not gonna tell you who I'm talking about. So let's do this. Let's release the sharks.
The spot is carefully chosen with no fishing boats around, giving our little cat sharks the opportunity to escape into deep waters. The release itself will be at 18 meters depth. It's up to our little one-year-olds to go the rest of the way on their own. Cat sharks live independently of their parents from day one, so they already have all the instincts needed to thrive. Last check, the environment seems to be safe. Then, the moment has come. Seeing them swim away is quite an emotional moment, and it feels good to return life where we can.
Every time we release sharks back in sea, it's like we took something from nothing and gave them a chance, and now they're back where they belong. It's an amazing feeling every single time.
But the successful work over the past 10 years also comes with its challenges. Incubating and releasing more than 360 catsharks has meant wear and tear on the equipment. While the glass tank itself can last forever, other essential parts, such as filters and the cooling system, are in need of upgrading.
You know that this is where we step in. To support this incredible work, the Planet Y community is funding a complete set of new tank equipment so Shark Lab Malta can continue their important work.
But this is only half of what Greg and his team are doing. Through campaigns and events, they raise awareness about sharks and their ecosystem. Because changing people's perception of sharks will ultimately lead to better protection. And of course, we want to bring support for this as well by financing the educational work of Shark Lab for a full year. Greg and his team are changing Malta's underwater world for the better, and they provide an example not only for a new method that others can copy worldwide, but also for a mentality that we all can learn from, that you don't need to be a biologist or an engineer to start working on solutions for our planet. Sometimes all you need is curiosity and determination. And if you're wondering how you can give back to nature, consider joining Planet Wild as a backer. We are completely community funded. Every month we go on a mission to bring back endangered species, protect our oceans, or rewild entire landscapes. The bigger this community grows, the bigger these missions will get. You can sign up with the link in the description or the QR code over here. Or go watch another video over here.